Good morning, everyone. Today in our second online class, we are going to discuss our chapter further on. Before starting the chapter, I want to tell you that you have to make a theme page of chapter number 1. This is the way you have to make the theme page. Chapter number, chapter name, learning objectives, need for food, sources of food, variety in food habits, how living things get food. And don't forget to mention date and day. After that, you have to write the keywords. Animals as source of food. So, till now we have discussed about plant as source of food. Plant are not only the things we get the food. There are some animals also we get the food from it. There are some animals also which from where we get the food. Like we get from animals we get meat, eggs, fish, seafood. Fish and seafood are rich in iodine and protein. And pulses are also rich in protein. We also get milk and honey. These are the food items which we get it from the animals. From meat we get it from goat, fish and seafood, you know that, eggs we get it from chicken, milk from cow, buffalo, goat, honey we get it from honeybees. So all these are what? These are the animals and these are the sources where we get the food from. In our environment there are two kind of organisms. One is autotrophs and other one is heterotrophs. Autotrophs means they prepare their food by themselves. They do not require anything. They have the capability to prepare their own food. Like plants. Plants can able to make their own food from the raw material which they get it from the environment. Like they prepare their food from carbon dioxide, water, which they get it from the environment. Heterotrophs. Heterotrophs means they are dependent on other. They cannot prepare the food from the raw material which are available in the environment. Like human beings. Human beings, we cannot prepare the food from, we cannot prepare our food from oxygen, from water, from carbon dioxide. Means we are dependent on autotrophs. Autotrophs prepare their food and we get the food from the autotrophs. So example of autotrophs are plants and example of heterotrophs are animals and human being. Eating habits of animals means we distribute the animals according to their eating habits. There are number of animals in our surrounding. There are variety of animals like amphibians, reptiles, mammals, and in mammals there are number of animals. In reptiles we have number of animals. So we characterize each animal according to their eating habits. So according to eating habit, we divide three category. One is herbivore, second is carnivore, and third one is omnivore. You must have heard this word herbs. Herbs means what? These are the short plants. So somewhat this word come from herb. So herbivore, what? Plant eaters, animal means they. Herbivores are kind of animals which totally dependent on plants only. They have sharp cutting teeth and flat grinding teeth. Example, cow and goat. Next one is carnivore. Carnivore means flesh eater animals. Means they are dependent on flesh. Means they eat other animals. They have sharp claws and jaws to hold the prey. And snakes and crocodile they swallow the whole animal and then digest it. Now we will do the checkpoint number 1. The raw material used for making food. What are the raw materials called? Ingredients. We call it ingredients. Next is the seed of cultivated grass, wheat and rice. Wheat and rice are also come in this blank. Next is the fruit used for obtaining oil, that is olive. From olive we get olive oil, and olive is the fruit. Olive are the fruit. Nutrient rich in pulses. Which nutrient rich in pulses? I told you before that it's protein. The nutrient rich in pulses are protein.